My name is Pablo Ibáñez. I am based at the London School of Economics, and I am delighted to be sharing some thoughts on the application of abuse of dominance provisions in digital markets. So then, the essence of the ideas I wanted to convey are encapsulated in this PowerPoint presentation. So the fundamental idea that I want to discuss in the coming minutes is that abuse of dominance cases in digital markets are different from other cases in two major respects. Then somewhat simplifying or to illustrate the point clearly, I would emphasize first that abuse of dominance cases in digital markets interfere with how products are made as opposed to how products are sold. And I will explain in some detail what I mean by this idea. And as a related consequence, remedial intervention is more complex in abuse of dominance cases in digital markets. So very often it involves interfering with the core of a company's business model, or it may involve redesigning a product. Such forms of intervention are by definition more complex. Right? And this complexity has implications, I will explain, both from a legal and from a policy and perspective. Right? And then first of all, I'd like to discuss the difference between how products are sold and how products are made. Then competition law, as traditionally understood, as applied over decades, was typically confined to the way in which products were sold, right? Then if one thinks of the traditional abuse of dominance categories, be it predatory pricing, tying, exclusivity obligation, rebates, and so on, all of those cases interfered with the relationships of a dominant firm with third parties. And it did not go beyond those business relationships with third parties. One consequence of this relatively modest form of intervention is that remedial action was not particularly demanding from the perspective of a competition authority. Intervention when cases address the way in which products are sold is straightforward. A negative obligation, an obligation not to do something, is enough. And this remedy can be implemented on a one-off basis. So from that perspective, these are cases that are modest in the sense that they don't get into the inner workings of a company. And because of that, the remedy is not particularly demanding. So hopefully I explained this, which is taken from a landmark EU competition law case called the Limites. This is what I mean in the context of this presentation by interfering with the way in which products are sold, right? Then the application of competition rules concerns the relationships between a supplier and its customers on the downstream market. And therefore, if exclusivity obligations are ever found to amount to an infringement of competition law, the remedy is simple: an obligation not to do something, a cease and desist obligation concerning, in this example, exclusivity obligations. In digital markets, very often, intervention demands going beyond the way in which products are sold and getting into the way products are made. As I mentioned in the introduction, this means second guessing or interfering at least with the design of products, that is to say, with the way in which different features are integrated into a single complex product, or intervention may also interfere with the very business model of a company, right? Or at least with the core of the business model. And in particular, with the models that companies follow to monetize their investments. As some examples of what I mean by interfering with business models. Well, for instance, interfering with a decision by a firm to go for an advertising-based model as opposed to a subscription-based one. Or it can be a decision to be vertically integrated as opposed to relying on third parties. And this is what I mean, getting into, so to speak, the black box that is the firm from a competitional perspective. Traditionally, the black box remained a black box. Intervention in digital markets very often means intruding into the black box. Right? And just to mention some examples, then Google Shopping is a landmark case which illustrates this idea. Well, this was the way in which Google integrated its various features, including Google Shopping, which is the one displayed in this example, following intervention by the European Commission in 2017. The design of the search engine changed in order to integrate on an equal footing third-party price comparison websites. In this case, we get into the black box of the firm and we tweak the design of the product to ensure that third parties are given equal treatment. Another case, this ongoing dispute between Apple and some app developers relying upon the App Store. Well, in this case, again, part of the dispute is about a decision related to the business model and the way in which Apple decides to monetize its investments and the way in which Apple decides to obtain remuneration. In this particular case, say, well, Apple decides to obtain a commission from some application developers as opposed to, for instance, obtaining all of its revenue from the sale of devices, right? So again, it goes to the core of a business model decision. And then here, if intervention takes place, it would involve, at least to some extent, intruding into the core of the company's business model and the model that the company has chosen to monetize its investments. All right, so then what are the consequences of this? Well, the key consequence is that even if we believe that intervention in a particular case is necessary, interfering with the way in which products are made as opposed to the way in which products are sold is by definition more complex, right? So then redesigning a product, altering a business model is inevitably more complex than simply imposing a cease and desist obligation on a dominant firm. And that means that it's more demanding for courts and authorities. The design of the remedy is by definition more complex. And as the experience of recent years shows, the monitoring and the implementation of the remedy are also more complex, right? So then the questions against this background and the questions that I want to contribute to this debate are from a policy perspective, one question that arises is, well, how often do competition authorities want to interfere with the way in which products are made? Right? Then from a policy prioritization perspective, this is an important decision. Proactive remedies of this kind, redesigning products, tweaking business models, are remedies or are forms of intervention that are more prone to errors and that may sometimes fail altogether. The question is, well, how often do competition authorities want to expose themselves to these sort of risky interventions? And another important question arises from a legal perspective. What is the legal treatment that should be given to these forms of intervention? Right? Then traditionally, if one looks at competition law, I would say on both sides of the Atlantic, typically it was quite deferential to anything that had to do with the black box of the firm. Decisions concerning vertical integration, decisions relating to business models, decisions to produce in-house as opposed to licensing, etc. If we take competition law intervention as a whole, if we examine the case, it becomes clear that traditionally competition law was quite differential. Several examples from the case law that can be drawn to illustrate this particular point. The question is, well, moving forward, even taking into consideration the features of digital markets, well, are there reasons to depart from this traditionally differential approach and moving more into an arena in which decisions relating to the design of a product or a business model are going to be subject to a case-by-case analysis of effects, or even are going to be presumptively unlawful, and therefore intervention will be made more frequent, or at least there will be no legal obstacles to intervention interfering with business models or with the design of products, right? So this is an important question, in particular for courts, as to, well, whether there are reasons to, from a legal standpoint, make it easier to interfere in this sense with business practices. I very much look forward to the discussions that will follow from this presentation and other similar ones. And I thank you very much again for the occasion given to share my thoughts. Thank you.